Good evening. I'm Adrian Arsenault.
And I'm Andrew Chang. Tonight, just in time for the holidays, more change for travelers.
I just really wish they would, you know, find a set of rules and just stick with them so that people can get back to doing normal things.
As the reality of Omicron sets in, the U.S. changes the rules. What you need to know if you're flying south this winter.
A teen hockey player faces racism on and off the ice.
I was just there to play hockey, and then people just had to ruin the experience for me.
The calls for action to stop Superman and the NHL superstar reaching out.
How a 100-year-old diary entry has a Regina gallery reviewing where some of its collection came from.
There's definitely mixed emotions, proud that we could take these steps, and then also that feeling of regret and shame.
Fly ball, left center, gone!
How baseball's off-season lockout could change the game this season. This is The National. After months of progress and right on cue for the holidays, there is growing uncertainty tonight about where the COVID-19 situation is headed.
Omicron is forcing a shift in strategy from governments here and elsewhere. Tonight, how some of those shifts affect you. Today, the U.S. announced it is tightening its airport testing rules, making it that much harder for Canadians to fly in. While here, provinces and territories are expanding their booster shot programs.
So we'll look into those third shots in a moment, but let's start off with those new U.S. travel restrictions kicking in on Monday. Here's Aaron Collins on what they mean for COVID-weary Canadians hoping to fly south.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas at Calgary's airport, one of the busiest travel seasons of the year, ramping up again.
Very, very excited to get out of the country into the warm weather and explore again.
But air travel is anything but normal this holiday season. News today that vaccinated Canadians flying to the U.S. will now need a negative COVID test within 24 hours of takeoff, down from 72.
I just really wish that they would, you know, find a set of rules and just stick with them.
A move the U.S. says is needed to slow the spread of the new Omicron variant.
This tighter testing timetable provides an added degree of protection as scientists continue to study the Omicron variant.
Despite those new measures, experts in the U.S. insist it's safe for vaccinated people to travel over the holidays.
Enjoy the holidays indoor with your family in a family setting. Many of us will have to travel during the holidays. What you do when you travel, you take care, you're prudent.
Even so, today's new rules are one more hurdle for Canadians hoping to fly south this winter.
You know, it's hard for us to make a decision, but we both know that time is of the essence.
If you are looking to book a flight to the U.S., some advice from an industry trying to get back off the ground.
Wait until we know more. That's what I would tell them. Or if they're going to book something that they're going to get full refundability on.
Fully vaccinated Canadians looking to drive to the U.S. won't be impacted by today's changes. They still don't need a COVID test at all to enter. But if you're leaving for more than 3 days, well, those travelers need one to get back. But some worry that all of that could change too.
I would hate to have to cancel my travel plans. However, I would rather know ahead of time that this is what I need to do.
So change is in the air for travelers heading south to the U.S., but so far at least no sense that those heading from the States to Canada will need a negative COVID test just 24 hours before they fly. Aaron Collins, CBC News, Calgary.